In the previous backlight process video, I showed you different methods of testing LED backlights. Well, what comes next after testing? The fixing, of course. Hello there, my name is Dominic and today we are going to fix the burnt LEDs. I will show you the different methods of fixing the problem. On top of that, I will also tell you why I don't recommend these types of repairs. In my line of work, I have come across many horrors as an attempt of fixing the problem. My methods will be much neater and cleaner than what you see on your screen right now. The first method is shorting the LED terminals directly. This involves removing the lens, the reflective layer, and the LED light. After unsoldering or hammering the LED out, a bead of solder is soldered across the two terminals. Since the LED lights are usually connected in series, this shortcut method usually works. The downside is that it causes a black spot on the screen. The second method is soldering a portion of the backlight strip onto the damaged LED. This is done by removing the damaged LED and soldering a replacement LED on top. You should check the porosity first before soldering anything. Only two solder points are required for this method. Sometimes your replacement LED strip might have a copper or aluminium track at the back. This will short the two terminals at the back, rendering your light useless. Placing some masking tape at the back will solve this problem. Please do not attempt to remove the aluminium or copper tracks at the back. They are very useful for heat transfer. The third method involves changing the whole strip with the burnt LED. In the first three methods, all repairs are done on the TV. The fourth method is different and is done by the pros. This involves placing the strip on a heating pad and removing the burnt LED. Another one is soldered onto place while being careful not to reverse the polarity. Edge-lit TVs can be fixed professionally using this method since they have very small and compact LED lights. I would recommend you watch the LED backlight construction video to better understand why these methods work. While these methods would work on one or two lights, repairing multiple lights at a time is impractical and a waste of time. I only recommend these types of repairs if 1. The TV is fairly brand new, meaning that most lights have good lifetime left, and 2. The spare part required is discontinued. Now, when I repair any backlight, I usually change the whole set. I usually don't care if only one LED is burnt, I change everything. Why? Because that is the correct way to do it. You see, backlights have a lifetime, just like your living room bulb. This lifetime is usually measured in hours, but the average is usually 10,000 hours. Now, when you fix one or two lights on a TV that has been working for years, you are doing zero work. This is because the next LED in line to fail could fail hours or weeks from your repair time. You see, backlight operates like a marathon. They all start at the same time, but not all will finish at the same time. I have repaired a TV 4 times in a span of 1 month. I used the second method above and the customer thought I was a quack. The TV was a 55-inch and since it had so many lights, the probability of another failure after repair was very high. The lifetime is a mean value. Some LED lights will fail at 7,000 hours while others will fail at maybe 4,000 hours. The best method of repairing backlight is to change the whole set. I hope you learned something new today. Thank you for watching and goodbye. Also, please don't forget to watch the rest of the videos in the backlight repair process playlist.